be similar.
Hayden Christensen returning to the suit.
What's a good second cruiser for someone who got the Des Moines first? What's a good second tier 10 cruiser? I'm going to say the Hindenburg. Because you can use a lot of the same... Because going up the Hindenburg line, you use a lot of the same lessons that you learned with the American cruisers.
Hindi or Zhao.
See, I would recommend more the Hindenburg than the Zhao, just because in today, in the modern day and age, Zhao isn't as... doesn't have the same place that Hindenburg does. Like, Zhao used to be, like, even up until a point, like, still the best cruiser, one of the best cruisers in the game. And now it's just not. Like, you're still better off with the, because Yoshino. If you want a Japanese cruiser, get a Yoshino. Wooster, if you got halfway up the line. That's true. That gets you, that, Wooster is another good one. Right, not fire. Nope. Gun arcs are too good, chat. Pepe hands. And that's true. Saru does have a very specific way he likes to teach his players to do what to do things. But what's funny is the fact that I was one of Saru's principal players, and I don't even have a I don't have a Des Moines. I have never gotten a Des Moines. I still don't have one.
Shame on you.
That being said, I can get one. I could get one right now if I wanted to.
Yeah, and, you know, I ground out Des Moines. It was among the first five ships that I got in Tier 10. And when I got the legendary module on it, holy Jesus.
Okay, that's the gearing shooting at me. Don't you die, ever. That's entirely my fault. Hey, that torpedo super early.
Yeah, like Stormy said, Petro is kind of a bad choice for new players. Yes.
Petro's what you do in a Petro is not what you do most of the time in other cruisers. You do what you do in Petro because the Petro is the Petro.
Petro is basically Tech 3 Stalin.
Yeah. If Moskva was still available as a Tech 3 ship, this would probably... This right here, Moskva would be what I would recommend, or the Hindenburg. Probably the Moskva, because Moskva will teach you how to tank. Moskva will teach you how to tank in a cruiser. Do I have a ship request?
We have an armor scheme request.
And what would that be? Spit hot fire! Welcome back to the channel. Good to see you. Welcome back.
I don't know to what ship, though. He just said show armor scheme.
Show armor scheme of what? The Moskva? The Kaba? What? What ship are we going over the armor of? I'll talk about it. I'll start lecturing, but I need to know what I need to talk about. The Petro.
Petro.
Okay, so why is the Petro as good as it is? Petro is as good as it is for two reasons. One, you do have a 25 millimeter armor deck, you do have a 25 millimeter nose. You still have the icebreaker, which goes all the way to the very tip of your ship, so it's very hard to citadel this thing in close range. But the other reason is you have your 50 millimeter armor deck, which means that Yamato can't overmatch it. You have a 180 millimeter armor belt that protects your citadel, which is pretty thick, by the way. Or that armor is pretty thick to get to the citadel. But the other reason, which actually doesn't showcase here very well, let me get a new port. They get something with water in it. So, how about my personal favorite? Where is it? Is right here, because it only sits about 10 feet out of the water. This right here is the single most overpowered thing about the Petro, is the fact it only sits 10 feet out of the water. And so you have to aim for this ridiculously small target, which you can angle very, very well. And if you don't miss this target, you're either going into the water or you're going to bounce off a 50 millimeter armor deck that you can't overmatch. See, this is the big weakness with Hindenburg. Hold on, where was it? Like, this was the big weakness with Hindenburg, especially nowadays with the proliferation of 430, 431 plus millimeter battleship guns, is the fact that it has a 30 millimeter center deck and a 30 millimeter upper belt. Because Montana, back when it was the Kurfürst, the Montana, and the Amato as the only three tier 10 battleships in the game, only one of those, which was the Amato, could overmatch you. Now, almost more tier 10 battleships can overmatch you than cannot. So the armor profile for Hindenburg is actually trash. This is actually bad. In fact, if you wanted to bring the Hindenburg back up to where it was in terms of strength, all you would have to do is take all of this 30, anywhere it says 30, and move it up to 32. Give it 32 millimeters of center deck plating, and all of a sudden, all of those 431 millimeter, all of those overmatching battleships suddenly can't overmatch it. Because, I mean, yeah, they gave it an extra heal, but that's not going to really do anything when you're getting Citadeled and you can't heal Citadels back. People still recommend Hindi as a first cruiser that you could have through the German line yourself. That's because Hindenburg is a great cruiser. It is. It just doesn't survive. You have to use light cruiser tactics in a Hindenburg in order to survive, because you're not fast, you're not very maneuverable, and your armor is low-key shit for fighting almost any battleship you'll run into, with the exceptions of Slava, Montana, Kurfürst, and that's it, because Yamato will overmatch you, Shikishima will overmatch you, Vermont will overmatch you, Kremlin will overmatch you, Conqueror will just fire a high explosive at you, Thunderer will overmatch you or fire high explosive at you, Republic will overmatch you. The Diabolical, welcome. Good to see you. Her standard build is spotter plane with range mod. That's the proper build. I like to play Hindenburg more with light cruiser tactics and use the reload mod because lol, Gunther Lugen's DPM. You actually overled so much going to US from Russia. Yeah, that'll happen. Okay, so we're talking about cruisers. Would y'all like to see the Hindenburg? Because we're talking about the Hindenburg as a possible second cruiser.
Got a question about Thunderer's AP.
Does Thunderer AP overmatch every ship in the game? No. And this is going into a subject of overmatching mechanics. The way overmatching works is what you do is you take your gun caliber, and you divide that by 14.3. So if we take our calculator, which is 457, we divide 457 by 14.3. We get 31.95, which means remember, those numbers don't round up. These numbers do not round up. 457 millimeter guns, which is your Thunderer, your Vermont, your Kremlin, all of that will overmatch up to 31.95 millimeters of armor plating. Even Republic. Republic's 431. So if we take 431 divided by 14.3, you come out with 30.13. And that's the big, big number that you have to be concerned about, is 30 millimeters of overmatching. Because most cruisers' armor plating, with the exception of the Puerto Rico, the Alaska, and the Russians, the Petro, the Stalingrad, and the Moskva, that those are not 30 millimeters. They will have 30 millimeters of armor plating for their center deck, which is the big thing. Shikishima and Yamato, though, at 460 and 510, but Yamato is 460. So if we take 460 divided by 14.3, you overmatch 32.167, which means you overmatch 32 millimeters of armor plating. Because see here, look. Let's take a look at some common cruisers. Yoshino has a 30 millimeter deck. Has a 30 millimeter deck, which means that 431 millimeters and above overmatches it, which means it just ignores the armor. It treats it like it's not there. It's an automatic pen at any angle. Which means that Republic, Thunderer, Kremlin, Vermont, Yamato, Shikishima, all overmatch it. Salem, same thing. 30 millimeter upper deck, 30 millimeter deck. It gets overmatched. Nevsky has a 30 millimeter deck, 25 millimeter upper deck, upper belt, gets overmatched. Smolensk is a fucking, like, floating tin can. It gets overmatched by everything. Hindenburg, this is the big thing, is look at all of this is all 30 millimeters. Like, 30 millimeter upper belt, 30 millimeter armor deck. Which means you need 431 millimeters or more to overmatch, which is most tier 10 battleships in the game, which is what you will be fighting. Minotaur is also a floating tin can. It's infamous for getting punched in the face by literally anything. Henry has a 30 millimeter upper deck, 30 millimeter armor belt, and a 25 millimeter bow and stern. This thing is infamous for being damageable if you touch it, which, because it is. Colbert, also a tin can, which is why for overmatching in battleships is really, really important. Like, most of the time nowadays, in the modern day and age, overmatching used to not be a really huge deal because it was only the Yamato that could really do it, because Yamato had the only gun caliber big enough, because Montana has 406. Kurfürst can get a maximum of 420. Conqueror has 419. But then they started coming out with all of the battleships that had 431. They came out with Republic. They came out with... So there was all of a sudden two that could do it. Because Republic came out. Then Kremlin came out. Then Thunderer came out. Then Vermont came out. In fact, of all the tier 10 battleships, in the game, I only don't have one of them. I don't have the Borgone. But the Borgone doesn't matter because it has 380 millimeter guns. Let's count how many can't overmatch. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. Well, 5. You have 5 of them that can't overmatch. Because Borgone can't overmatch... Well, 6. Hold on a second. Montana can't overmatch you. Slava can't overmatch you. Conqueror can't overmatch you. Borgone can't overmatch you. And Kerr first can't overmatch you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 tier 10 battleships cannot overmatch you. But here's the thing. How many of those battleships that can overmatch you, Yamato, Shikishima, Kremlin, Vermont, Republic, Thunderer, how many of those are played versus the ones that came? Ohio. So yeah, over... So, like, just over 50... Over half of the tier 10 battleships that you will play against all can overmatch you in a cruiser. But I say overmatch, they don't just overmatch your bow. That's not what we're talking about. What we're talking about is the center deck. Is this part right here. Which is what most battleships aim for. They aim for center. It's just like proper shooting a gun. They aim for center mass. Because you're most likely to get the most amount of damage and hit the Citadel anywhere in this area right here. Des Moines is a great example. Because this is like classic, super classical armor profile. Because you have your 27mm bow, you have your 30mm belt, you have your 30mm deck, and you have your 152mm Citadel armor belt right there. This is super classic armor profile for a cruiser. So in most of the time in a cruiser nowadays, your best chance of survival is literally either not getting hit or not getting shot at. Which is why you see a lot of people all liking to hide, because they have no ability to tank whatsoever. Because it's like, if I try to angle properly and angle this armor at like the 30 degrees or the 40 degree, the 30 degrees to get the proper auto bounce angle, it doesn't matter because I can just punch straight through that. I can literally just punch straight. I can punch straight through your nose and hit your Citadel award ship. Or even if I aim miss and the shells fly backwards, I'm just going to pin through your armor belt and get full pins on your belt, armor belt and superstructure. And you can go fuck yourself. Screw you and your armor. But yeah, that's what armor overmatching means. Is you want to take whatever gun caliber you have and divide it by 14.3, just so we can review. And then that is the armor profile that your guns can overmatch. Musashi also? Yes, the Musashi. So yes. The Musashi's tier 9. I'm talking about the tier 10s. But most of the time at tier 10, all the tier 10 battleships that you will face, more of them than not, can overmatch cruiser armor plating. It only really comes into matter when you're fighting your tier 8s and your tier 9s, because when you're fighting tier 8s and 9s, that's when you start seeing a higher number of 406mm and 380mm, which can't hurt, which don't overmatch 300 or don't overmatch 30mm armor plating or more. Yes, Cries and Palmern. Because the Palmern is not a mini Kerfurst, it is a super Tirpitz. It is literally a Tirpitz, but bigger. Yeah, honestly, Ohio is kind of the superior Montana. Because it has the better survivability with the Massachusetts heel. It's better in your close quarters fights. It has cruiser overmatch. Because it can literally tell any cruiser to go fuck themselves. Screw you and your angling. Which is why the Russians, so your Moskva, with its 155mm armor belt, which you can angle, its 50mm upper belt, and its 50mm deck, and its 50mm icebreaker, used to be so stupidly strong, is because you can't overmatch it. You want to kill a Moskva? Your only two choices are to either burn it down or get it broadside and just punch through its citadel, which like sits stupidly high out of the water. Stalingrad, which replaced the Moskva, is the same reason, because look at this thing. You have your icebreaker, which goes all the way to the front, You have your armor belt, which is 50 millimeters. You have your deck, which is 50 millimeters. It's super tanky for the same reason. But in fact, yeah, Mosfa is at a slight bit of an advantage because Mosfa's icebreaker sits a little higher in the water than Stalin's Grad's does. So you can get more consistent damage on the nose of a Stalingrad if you shoot right here at the nose, at the top part of the nose. Mm-hmm. But Petro, and this is why Petro is so fucking stupid now, is because it has the same 50 millimeter belt and deck. You can't overmatch it with centerline fire. And if you do manage, most of the time, this is what you have to shoot at, is your 6 feet of freeboard. Look how low it sits in the water. It sits about as high in the water as the gearing does. It literally sits as high out of the water as the gearing, which is a destroyer. Look at this. Gearing. Petro. Gearing. Petro. Russian napkin technology. Yes. Yes, indeed. So that's the big thing when it comes to cruisers, is you just can't get shot at. Anyway, the Zhao. Let's take a look, because this is the Zhao. That's another one I forgot to go over. You have...
Oh, I'm gonna drop out. Have a good one. Catch you later.
No worries, Epso. Thanks for hanging out. This was the other big thing, is the Zhao has 30mm upper belt, 30mm deck. Which was nice. It used to be really nice. Now, this thing literally gets clapped out of existence if you touch it. And it doesn't have the health to survive, because it only has 41,000 health. Only has 41,000. Which means if you get Citadeled by... If you get Citadeled by a Shikishima, that's half your health, gone.
Teammate gained.
Snow Surfer, DS, thank you for the follow, I appreciate it. 07. I'm on my soapbox right now. Secret documents, commoner. Never worry about C's teleporter is alive. This is true. But Zhao gets slapped out of existence. Yoshino, same thing. It has the same armor profile that the Zhao does, but it deals more damage than the Zhao. And you have better pen because of the guns. Which is the thing. Like, it basically boils down to, if you want to survive in a cruiser, just don't get shot at. Because the only cruisers in the game that are capable of tanking getting shot at by battleships is your Petro, your Mosfa, your Stalingrad. That is, and your Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico, Alaska, Goliath is another one. Yeah. Where's the Goliath? If you take a look at the Goliath, take a look at its armor profile. This is why Goliath is taken in competitive, is because it has this right here. 40 millimeter deck, which means you can't overmatch it. Which means the battleships can't overmatch the center deck. However, they can overmatch the upper belt. Which is why Goliaths tend to play further back. But Saru's right. Goliath's HE does shit on everything. Survivability isn't everything. You have to take survivability when it comes to a ship, and also compare it to its damage output and the type of damage that it does. But that's a whole nother different can of worms. Let's not mention the Goliath is just... It's fun, not much. Yeah. Train of thought. But yeah, it's just, you can't, unless you're a Stalingrad, a Mosfa, or a Petro, your best way to mitigate damage is just not getting shot at. Because if a battleship is shooting at you, you can't really do anything against it. You can, however, this is all armor schemes, mind you, for dealing with battleships. Now we're dealing with cruisers. If you're dealing with cruisers, most of your crew armor plating is good. But most of the time, when it comes to your battleships, your armor profile is just going to tell you to go fuck yourself. I'm going to get into a game now because I've been talking for like half an hour, almost 45 minutes about armor profiles, and I haven't really played anything. I hope you people learned something. But let's look at the lecture in practice. Let's take the Hindenburg.